The court calls the matter of Bynum versus Bynum, case number 2021-5199-DO. All parties and attorneys, please state their name and appearance for the record.
Good morning, Serafina Conference here on behalf of the plaintiff, David Bynum.
Good morning, and present is Mr. Bynum. We'll have him sworn in a moment. Today's hearing is being done by remote technology. The contents of this video may be the official record or proceeding of the State of Michigan's 9th Judicial Circuit. Unauthorized duplication, distribution, or alteration of said content is strictly prohibited. Today's date and time set for a settlement conference. I did receive a stipulation to take proofs on June 24th, 2021. Before we went on the record, Ms. Coffran said she's turned in the judgment divorce. I'm sure she has. It's just with everything still going on, it may take a minute to find. So what I'll do is I'll preserve proofs today. We'll look for the judgment. If I have any difficulties, Ms. Coffran will contact your office, but I'm sure it's in the building. We'll just get it as soon as we can.
Okay, and I've also, I've just emailed it to Carlia if she wants, if that's easier.
If you just emailed it, then I'll probably have her print it before proofs are done. So with that, Mr. Bynum, I'll have you raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear or affirm, tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth self you got?
I do.
Please state your full name, spelling your first and last name for the record.
David Christopher Bynum, DavidBynum.
Okay. With the stipulation to take proofs, Ms. Cochran, you may inquire.
Okay, thank you. David, were you married to Jacqueline Bynum, then Jacqueline Clayton, in Orlando, Florida on December 27th, 1994?
Yes, I was.
Do you recall signing a complaint for divorce on February 11th, 2021?
I do.
Did you continuously live in Michigan for at least 180 days before you signed that complaint?
Yes.
And had you been living in or resident of Kalamazoo County for at least 10 days before you filed the complaint?
Yes.
In the complaint, you stated that there had been a breakdown of the marital relationship so that the objects of matrimony had been destroyed and there remained no reasonable likelihood that the marriage could be preserved. Was that true when you signed the complaint?
Yes.
Is that true still today?
Yes.
Is there any chance of reconciliation?
No.
Can you please briefly just tell the court why the marriage broke down?
Financial reasons and not communicating and not getting along, basically.
Okay. To the best of your information and belief, is Mrs. Bynum pregnant?
No.
Okay. Have you and Mrs. Bynum been able to arrive at a settlement on all property and spousal support issues?
Yes.
And you have no minor children, correct?
No.
Okay.
No.
And the settlement on all property and spousal support issues has been incorporated into the proposed judgment of divorce that you signed?
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
Did you have a chance to thoroughly review it before you signed it?
I did.
Okay. With regards to spousal support, the judgment provides that neither you nor Mrs. Bynum is paying or receiving spousal support and that both of you have waived the right to come back to court to ask for spousal support in the future. Do you recall that?
Yes.
Okay. Do you understand that that agreement is final, binding, non-modifiable?
Yes.
Okay. With regards to the property settlement provisions, do you believe that those are fair and equitable?
Yes.
Okay. Do you understand that you had a right to a trial in this case? You were not required to settle your case?
Yes.
You understand that if you were to have proceeded to a trial, you could have presented testimony and documents and other evidence, and Judge Pierangeli would have heard all of it and could have made a decision that could have been better for you, worse for you, or about the same for you?
Yes.
Okay. Outside of that, which is detailed in the judgment and the accompanying qualified domestic relations order, have there been any other promises in connection with the divorce?
No.
Okay. I move for entry of the proposed judgment of divorce. It's been signed by everyone. The quadro has been prepared and we've signed it. It's my understanding Attorney Town is going to be submitting that shortly.
Okay.
Okay. Mr. Bynum, your attorney's covered everything, but is there anything else you want the court to be made aware of?
No, thank you.
Well, we did get a copy of the consent judgment divorce that has been signed by both parties and their attorneys. I do believe it to be fair and equitable of both parties. Testimony shows me that there has been a breakdown of the marriage relationship to the extent that the objects of matrimony have been destroyed, and there remains no reasonable likelihood the marriage can be preserved. I've signed the judgment divorce, making it official. We'll get it out to both attorneys to get to their clients. Any questions, sir?
No, sir. No, Your Honor.
Thank you, and best of luck to you, and thank you for your hard work, Ms. Crawford.